I spent the war days, May 10, 15, 1940, at Pa Hans and Etty's house. The first bomb fell on Amsterdam. Rotterdam was devastated. Things started to change, slowly at first. I moved back to The Hague, commuting weekly to Amsterdam. The psychologist Julius Speer, who was a pupil of Carl Jung, surfaced early 1941. He was to become Etty's closest friend. Speer introduced psychology into our lives. We were familiar with philosophy, we were familiar with sociology. But Psych 101 had not yet been invented. And here was this guy, and he looked into your hands, and he proclaimed that you had a positive bonding with your father and a negative attitude towards your mother. Wow. And then the aforementioned Jungian collective subconscious and concepts like anima and animus, and above all, ichhaftigkeit. Before Speer, petty bourgeois behavior had been bad. Now, ichhaftigkeit had taken over its place as the most undesirable behavior. What is ichhaftigkeit? Not an easy concept. It is more than self-centeredness or egocentricity. Maybe ego emphasis is a good term. Rereading some of the correspondence between Speer and me during the first half of 1942, I have come to the approximation that, in their point of view, ichhaftigkeit is that what stands between a person and that person's source of real, ultimate inner strength. I do want to read this once more because I think it is very central in understanding Etty's attitude. It is their point of view is ichhaftigkeit is that what stands between a person and that person's source of real, ultimate inner strength. I believe that Etty would use the word God for the letter. Anyway, as the outside threats became more and more menacing, the theory, as I perceived it, was this. By overcoming one's ichhaftigkeit, one's ego emphasis, through self-analysis and subsequent inner growth, one could reach that ultimate inner strength supposedly present in every human being and triumph over whatever challenges the outside world would present, while along the way helping others. Well, it did not work for me. So, in the fall of 1942, our ways parted. Speer died. I went underground by becoming a Gentile au pair, a live-in nanny and maid. And Etty had already started her journey to Westerbork, where, in her letters, she would eventually create her masterwork.